Deputy Shane Ross, please, on behalf of the technical group. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Colin Culler. In response to what the Taoiseach said to Deputy Doherty, I'd like to make what I think is a constructive suggestion and to test the Taoiseach's response to it. As the House will know, the Referendum Commission on Tuesday ruled that there could be no delay under the 1994 Referendum Act in the fiscal treaty to which you have pledged yourself and your party. That is absolutely true, and it is legally true. In response to that, Taoiseach, I have a very short bill to propose to the House today, proposing that you.
Sorry, would you please allow the deputy to speak? Thank you.
Thank you.
And I remind the deputy that there's a procedure to go through in relation to this bill, which is on the order paper here. Thank you.
Proposing that the Taoiseach and the government may, not to compel you, but may, if it so fits, thinks, and if it is fit, may change that date if events overtake what happens to the treaty.
Sorry, would you ever stay quiet? Thank you. I would be grateful. You can't stay quietly in the chamber. Thank you.
Please proceed.
Will you too stay quiet? Thank you. Now, would you please proceed without interruption?
Such a bill would take a day or 2 days to get through this House and the Senate. It would give you the facility, if you wished, and if events changed, to actually postpone that treaty to a date which is relevant. Because, and let me put you one good reason why this should happen, and that is, in an opinion poll today, where you came out on top, there are a large number, 35% of people, who are either confused or don't know what the situation is, and who wish, and
thank
who
you,
wish,
Deputy, we're over time, thank you,
and who'd wish it to be clarified.
Thank you.
It would be very important.
Could I have your question, please? Thank you.
It is important, Taoiseach, that the clarity which we need is given to the people by delaying events if it's necessary. And the reason why people don't know the answer, the reason why people don't know, is because they're unclear, not about the treaty itself, because the treaty itself,
thank you, Deputy, you're way over time, would you please resume your seat,
okay,
thank you.
As everybody in this House knows,
thank you,
is about,
thank
is
you.
Simply...
Thank you, will you resume your seat? Thank you. I want to ask you again to resume your seat.
Thank you.
Okay. Taoiseach, sorry. There's a procedure that has gone through here. I have before me a request officially on the order paper for today regarding the moving of the bill, which will be dealt with later. And it's up to the House to decide the procedure, whether the government accept or reject. So would you please be conscious of that in replying to the debate? Thank you.
First,
thank you. Would you please? Thanks very much. Deputy, would you take a pill there for a moment, please? Stop getting excited.
I couldn't even hear Deputy Ross.
I know. Will you just get me
I saw you were a medical doctor.
No, I'm just advising you to stay quiet. Thanks. Thank you very much. Yeah. I'm not insulting you at all. You haven't lost your sense of humour, I presume, have you? No, good. Thank you.
I can correlate. The Referendum Commission have already made it clear that it is not possible to postpone the referendum. Secondly, it wouldn't be a good idea anyway to postpone it, because what this country needs is certainty, not indecision. We have a decision, all of us as individual citizens, on the 31st of May, and we have an opportunity, I believe, as people, to make a very strong statement that as a country, that we are certain about the euro, that we want to have stability in the euro, that we want to have confidence for investors in this country, and that there's no question about Ireland's relationship with the euro, and that as a country, that we want to have access to emergency funding if we were ever to need it. And there needs to be certainty brought to that question, and that certainty will be brought when the people make a decision on the 31st of May. I do not intend to accept Deputy Ross's bill. I think it is a rather extreme measure that he's introducing here to avoid a situation where he can't make up his mind as to where he stands on the treaty. I was in Deputy Ross's constituency. I was in Deputy Ross's constituency on Saturday, and I met many voters there who can't understand why Deputy Ross is not supporting the government and supporting this treaty, which is the right and the sensible thing to do. I do acknowledge that there are many people who have yet to make a decision as to how they will vote in the treaty. That is why the government has made more information available for this treaty than has been made for previous treaties. There is an information campaign which is underway, which is continuing, informing people about the contents of the treaty. Between now and voting day, certainly I will, and I know that my colleagues in government and the two parties in government, supported by others, will be seeking a yes vote from every individual citizen in this country, because it is the right thing to do in the country's national interest.
Thank you. Deputy Ross, 1 minute.
Thank you, and welcome to the constituency, Deputy Gimmel. I was in Paris, actually, last week, and they were wondering. I met a lot of people there. And they were wondering why you had to go over to Paris to do an interview for Morning Ireland. But that's a different issue. And to find that the man you went over to see, Monsieur Hollande, had fled to Tulle when he heard you were coming. Because, but perhaps you could answer the question. Why will you not just take the facility for yourself, the ability to change this particular referendum date if events overtake it? Yes. Because events, as you know, are overtaking it by the day. On the 17th of June, and the Tánaiste will know this, on the 17th of June, it is a key date, and that is 1 month from today. There are elections in France which will affect, whether you like it or not, the austerity treaty, as it's called here, or the fiscal treaty, as it's called by others. But they will affect it. Also on the 17th of June, there is an election now called Greece. Those events are earthquake. They are epoch-shaking in terms of Europe, and you're insisting that will not affect the fiscal treaty at all. Will you not just take this power upon yourselves in order to facilitate a change in events which will make the treaty irrelevant?
Well, first of all, as the Referendum Commission has made clear, it is not possible to postpone the referendum. And secondly, it is not a good idea to do so. What this country needs, particularly at a time of uncertainty in Europe, and we're seeing uncertainty in Greece, is we need ourselves, this country, our people, individual citizens, make a clear statement that we want stability and we want certainty. And every individual citizen in this country has the opportunity to make that statement very clear themselves in the privacy of the ballot box on the 31st of May, that we want a stable euro, that we want certainty about our own future in terms of emergency funding, that we want certainty and stability in this country so that investors out there will have the confidence to continue investing in Ireland, to create jobs here and to get our economy to recover. The idea that we should stand back and wait to see what way the wind is blowing. What do you think investors are going to do? I attended a meeting yesterday morning organised by the American Chamber of Commerce, 100 senior executives of American companies who are investing here. What kind of report do you think they would send back to their headquarters if I was to say to them, we're postponing the referendum, we're going to wait to see what way the wind is blowing?
Thank you.
If we end up in that kind of situation, we're going to wait to see what way the wind is blowing, investors will do exactly the same thing. We need to have certainty, we need to have stability, so that investment will come to this country. And what has happened in France is something that this government welcomes, because it contributes to the growth agenda and to promoting growth and job creation in Europe, which is very much in harmony with what the government itself is doing here in order to promote growth and stimulus in our domestic economy so that we can get more people back to work, our economy to grow and get the economy to recover and make this a better country.
Thank you. That completes needless questions for today.